Now, in the last part of our 16th lecture, we will discuss the theory of vector fields. This is section 1.6 and the last topic of the first chapter. So, we are able to complete the first chapter in 16 lectures, and after this, we will start with the second chapter. So, this is the theory of vector fields. We are having two fields. One we call is electric field and the other we call is magnetic field. Now, we will not only discuss the fields but will also discuss their potentials. We know that electric and magnetic field are both vector in nature, and there are some facts associated with these fields. We will not be considering at the moment their time variation, but will only consider their space variation. So, the time variation we will cover in the coming lectures. But up to this point, we are only discussing their space variation or their spatial variation. We know about the electric field, that this electric field is diverging. And we have proved this thing, that divergence of E is equal to rho over epsilon naught. It means that the divergence of E is not equal to zero. Similarly, for the magnetic field, we are having that the divergence of magnetic field is equal to zero, while the curl of magnetic field is, this is equal to zero. So, we will go towards some non-zero component, and that is that the curl of the magnetic field is equal to mu naught J. It means that the curl of magnetic field is not equal to zero, means it's non-zero. Now, we will discuss the physical importance of this thing or the physical interpretation of this thing. When divergence of electric field is non-zero, means the electric field is diverging. So, when a field is diverging, it means its line will never curl. Its line will never twist, means they are diverging, they are going in a straight line. So, this means that a diverging electric field never curls. It will never curl. And if I look here to the magnetic field, and the magnetic field says that the curl of a magnetic field is non-zero, means the lines are actually curling and its divergence is equal to zero, means they are not diverging at all. When they are curling, then it means they cannot diverge, because for divergence they are supposed to go in a straight line, and that's why we write that a curling magnetic field never diverges. It never diverges. So, we are having a diverging electric field which will never curl, means its lines will go in a straight line, and a magnetic field which is curling, so it will never diverge. Its divergence will be equal to zero. Now, in this situation, it means that this electric field is the result of something means electric field is generated due to something. So this electric field is the result of something which is varying in a straight line. It never curls. And that's why we write the electric field. This is the electric field, and it is the result of something which vary in a straight line. So it means it is the result of the variation, which I call is gradient, because gradient is a directional variation. Gradient is the derivative in a certain direction, space derivative in a certain direction. So it means that here it is the gradient of something. Now what should be next? It means that electric field is the gradient of a potential. Now that potential is supposed to be a scalar quantity, because we cannot take gradient of a vector quantity. And that is why we write the potential of this electric field is V, and this is a scalar quantity. And now this V will varies in a certain direction, then it generates electric field. Now keep in mind one thing, that the reference frame is also important here. When we are studying the electric field, then the electric field is that you are having a source charge, and then how much it repels the electric, another charge which you call is a test charge. And the direction of the electric field is in this direction. So this is your reference point, and from here you are seeing that how this one is moving away from it. When you consider potential, then potential is having a different reference frame. You consider a test charge, and that test charge you are moving towards a certain source charge, and how much work is done in bringing this charge from this point to this point, and you are doing work against the electric field. So in this situation, you are moving the charge in this direction, while the electric field from this charge means it is away from it. So if this is potential V in this direction, then electric field according to this situation is here. So they are in opposite direction to each other, and that's why we write a minus sign here, and this minus sign is due to the reference frame. So electric field, we can say that this is the negative gradient of electric potential. There can be no other way. There is no reasoning for this one, that why this one is scalar, because we are taking gradient of it. So by definition, it is supposed to be a scalar quantity. We can, in other words, say, as this is the most studied topic, so we say that this electric potential is the scalar analog of electric field, because it is just the variation of this one. The variation of potential you call is electric field. Now come over here. Here it says that the magnetic field curls. It cannot diverge. So it means that when the magnetic field cannot diverge, then this magnetic field is the result of something which is curling. Del cross means it is curling, because it cannot be the result of something that can move in a straight line. It is curling, and for that reason we write that this magnetic field is the result of something which is curling, and that we write is magnetic vector potential. Now we cannot take the curl or the divergence of a scalar quantity. So this magnetic potential is supposed to be a vector quantity by definition here, that it cannot be a scalar quantity just like that one, because the two scenarios are different. So if we are having this question that why electric potential is scalar in nature and why magnetic potential is vector in nature, so the definition or the source of the definition is here, because that electric field is diverging, this magnetic field is not diverging, it is curling, and for that reason the magnetic field, the magnetic vector potential, is the curl of the magnetic vector potential is resulting in the magnetic field. Now whether there is a cross symbol here or not, so it is not here, because the magnetic means what direction it will give us. This is the variation. This whole we call is the curl of it. Now if they will be magnetic vector potential will be curling in one direction and the magnetic field will be curling in the other direction, then there will be a minus sign here. But in this situation there is no minus sign, because they are in the same direction, and this gives us the one of the very fundamental thing, that when this B is the result of something curling, then it means that its divergence will always be equal to zero, because we know that the divergence of this something which is curling is always equal to zero. Unless and until we are having a magnetic monopole, means a single charge, a single magnetic charge, then the divergence will be non-zero, and we will have the possibility of a vector, of a scalar potential for the magnetic field as well. But as we are having dipoles, we are having the result, means the phenomenon is the curling one. The electric field lines are always curling. If I consider a positive charge, then the lines are diverging from this one. The lines are diverging, so it's a monopole, it's a single polarity, it's a single charge here. But for a dipole, now the lines will be not like this, but they will be curling, and this line which is here will curl like this, this line will also curl like this, and similarly these as well. So they will be curling toward each other, and the divergence will come out to be zero. For these lines we will say that they are curling at infinite distance, mean at very long distance they are curling as well, but at the instant, means for a short distance, they seems to be diverging, but they are curling as well. Now look here about the electric potential. The electric potential V is the work done on a unit magnitude of charge. So here, by the same analogy, if I come to the magnetic vector potential, then the magnetic vector potential will also be, this is defined as, and here this one is defined as, that this is the work done on the unit magnitude of current. So this is the energy per unit charge. This one is the energy per unit current, per unit magnitude of current. So this way, this is the Helmholtz theorem or the theory of vector fields. We discussed the vector and the scalar potentials of both the fields. Both the fields are vector in nature, but one has the potential is a scalar, while the other is having the potential is a vector quantity. The reason behind them is that here the divergence is non-zero and here the curl is non-zero. We are having here for this one, when I will write the Faraday's law, no, not at this moment, but you know that this one, del cross E is equal to minus curly B over curly T. This is the situation, but as I stated earlier, that at the moment we are not considering the time variation of the electric or magnetic field, so this one is equal to zero, and here we say that the curl of it is equal to zero. When I come over here, then the divergence of this is zero, while the curl of this is not equal to zero, and due to these two differences, one field is the result of a varying potential in a line, so it is supposed to be a scalar quantity, while the other is the variation or the curling of a vector field, because we cannot take the curl or the divergence of a scalar quantity. So this is the end of chapter first. We have covered this whole chapter, means we have covered all the topics of it, we have solved all the examples of it, and we have covered some problems as well. Hopefully soon we will start with the next chapter, which is the actual start of the electrostatics. This chapter was a comprehensive chapter, and this chapter is very necessary for understanding rest of the electrodynamics, because some fundamental theorems are here, and then it will be easy for us to cover the rest of the chapters very easily and quickly. So thank you for staying with me for this long session of 16 lectures on the chapter first, and hopefully soon we will start with the next chapter. Thank you.